Returning a spacecraft safely back to Earth is a challenge that started long before the shuttle. It's troubled engineers for decades. Their designs must overcome the heat generated by the returning spacecraft's speed.
Orbital velocity is 17,500 miles an hour. You need to go from that speed to essentially zero, coming through the atmosphere with a tremendous amount of friction between the actual molecules of the air and the spacecraft itself.
The atmosphere is like a fluid, and it slows the spacecraft down. That generates a lot of heat, thousands of degrees. When you're dealing with stuff that's that hot, that's dangerous.
In the 1950s, the military conducts the first reentry tests with ballistic missiles. Their success proves that it's possible to return an object from space. As the nuclear race evolves into a full-blown space race, the U.S. is keen to test reentry with animals. In 1959, a joint Army-Navy mission launches two monkeys, Abel and Baker. Their 16-minute ride in the nose cone, once designed for a nuclear warhead, proves the idea can work.
It was one of the first tests of being able to show that you might be able to eventually send human beings into space safely and get them back to Earth.
The next goal? Land a human after a full Earth orbit.